Patients who have had a cesarean section have more difficulty becoming pregnant again. They also have lower success rates when transferring an embryo to the uterus during IVF. Why does this happen? It may be because the uterus doesn't heal correctly after the C-section. How do you know if this has happened to you? Is there any way to fix it? I am fertility expert Dr. Randy Morris, MD. Stay tuned and I will answer all of your questions. During a cesarean section, the obstetrician cuts into the wall of the uterus, removes the fetus, and then sews the walls back together. Over the next few months, that incision begins to heal. The incision will form a scar, just like you see when an incision is made in the skin. The thickest portion of the uterine wall is made of muscle. It is called myometrium. This is what gives the uterus its strength. If the uterus heals correctly, the entire muscle layer will come together, like this. Sometimes, however, the inner portion of that muscle does not heal together. This can leave a gap or defect in the muscle layer. This is most commonly referred to as an isthmocele. You may also hear it referred to as a uterine niche, cesarean scar defect, or diverticulum. How do you know if you have an isthmocele? Occasionally, your doctor may be able to see an isthmocele with a routine transvaginal ultrasound. More commonly, it is diagnosed by first squirting salt water into the uterine cavity with a catheter before an ultrasound. This is known as a hysterosonogram or saline ultrasound. Here is an example of a hysterosonogram with a normal uterine cavity. Here is a uterus with an isthmocele. The fact that these defects can be filled with fluid is important. Although we don't know exactly how an isthmocele makes it harder to become pregnant, one theory is that it may cause fluid to be retained in the uterine cavity, and this could interfere with the ability of an embryo to implant. Recently, researchers did an analysis to determine the impact of having a previous cesarean section on the chance for a live birth from IVF. This was a fairly large analysis that combined a number of studies with over 75,000 patients. When they compared the live birth rate between people who had an isthmocele and people who had a previous C-section but did not have an isthmocele, they found that having an isthmocele reduced the chance for a live birth by about 40%. They then looked at people who had an isthmocele and had fluid in the cavity and found that this was associated with a 65% lower chance for pregnancy. But people with an isthmocele without fluid in the uterus had the same chance for live birth as people without an isthmocele. So why exactly was the live birth rate lower? The embryos implanted in the uterus less often, and when they did, they also miscarried more often. What can you do if you have an isthmocele to improve your chance for a live birth? Remember, accumulation of fluid in the uterus is the main factor which impacts your chances. Avoiding this fluid accumulation is the key to higher success rates. Here are three tips. Number one, before performing an embryo transfer, monitor for fluid with ultrasound. If fluid develops, cancel the transfer and try again later. The fluid may not develop the next time. Number two, fluid accumulates much more commonly before a fresh embryo transfer, so try performing a frozen embryo transfer instead. Three, surgery to fix an isthmocele may be an option for people with persistent fluid accumulation, though there isn't as much data yet to show how effective this might be. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. If you've had a C-section, make sure you look for an isthmocele before your embryo transfer. If you have one but don't see fluid in the uterine cavity, you should be okay to proceed. Otherwise, cancel your transfer and try our tips for avoiding it the next time. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.